At your service, sir. Travel route is confirmed. Travel route is confirmed.
Take it slowly. Take it slowly.
Packed and ready, Admiral. Unless you're worried about the captain's flare.
No. We cannot wait.
Intruder alert.
Imagine if we hadn't gone through the proper channels.
Officer, I am Admiral Davos, commander of this expedition. You were not expected.
Cipher 9, Imperial Intelligence.
An intelligence agent? Of course. You must excuse our caution. Hoth is not a world that forgives mistakes, a lesson that scarred me long ago.
Weapons down, everyone.
We are in the midst of a delicate operation. These men are preparing to follow me to the Starship Graveyard.
The Minister of Intelligence says I'm to assist your men and ensure the interests of the Empire.
I see. Months ago, I could have accommodated this. Now, I'm afraid we approach the crisis point, and I cannot afford additional risk. Commander, torture him and find out what he knows, then kill him. Still alive. Don't bother returning to base. Captain Firth is gone and Admiral Davos bribed most of the others.
You were with Search and Recovery?
Correct. There is a location beyond the frozen lake. You'll find answers. Coordinates sent.
Have you been watching me?
We've been watching the sensors. Picked up blaster fire and assumed things had gone wrong. Go. Thent out.
Take it slowly. What is all this?
Sir, sorry for not contacting you sooner. No one thought Admiral Davos's men would actually start shooting. Ensign Rena Temple, Chiss Expansionary Defense Force, welcome to Zero Station.
Since I arrived on Hoth, I've been lied to, marked for death, and nearly frozen. I want an explanation.
I plan to give you one, sir, along with a heating pack. You do look a bit chilled. This is a top-secret Chiss Ascendancy installation. Self-sufficient, running in parallel with the above-ground outposts. Paranoia at work.
But our paranoia paid off.
And this is our base commander, Aristocra Saganu.
Ensign Temple speaks highly of Imperial intelligence. She convinced me the Admiral Davos situation warranted bringing you in.
He ordered his men to torture me. I'd like to know why.
My agents have been watching Admiral Davos for months. We became suspicious when he brought in his own crew, officers loyal to him, and covered it with bribes. Lately, he brought heavy equipment and guns, built an army for his expedition to the starship graveyard. You threatened his control.
A career admiral doesn't commit treason out of the blue.
He must be after the graveyard salvage, prototype technology, military databanks. It could make him unimaginably wealthy. I won't proceed without Imperial sanction. Grant it, and we can stop Admiral Davos and his plans together.
I'm in. What's our next move?
The White Moor pirates control the wastelands between here and the starship graveyard. The Admiral's been sending his people out there for weeks.
My scouting party caught them burying some sort of supply caches. We don't know what the Admiral's caches are for, but if you could get us reconnaissance scans, they might give us a lead on the man himself.
First we learn what he's up to, then we close in.
These are the drop point locations. Contact me when you get the scans, and we'll find our man. Chiss Honor.
Take it slowly.
To hear from you. We've been receiving the feed from the data arrays, and what we've learned is quite interesting. We had assumed there were one, perhaps two groups of Tals out there. We found six. Had we attacked earlier, we would have gotten one group and the other five would have gone to ground.
Now that we've tracked them, it's time to exterminate them.
Commander Triton and I believe we have the answer.
The good part is we know how many Tals there are. We have devised a plan to put the Tals in position for a killing blow. Their supplies, weapons, medical equipment, and the high-calorie food they require, all of it is stored in one central location. They may be adapted to the cold, but without their supplies, they wouldn't last a week.
What about their inevitable retaliation?
We expect it. No Tals commando will give up easily.
If I were them, and suddenly without food, I would raid this base. So we will amplify our defenses here and spring the trap shut. Unfortunately, getting out their supplies may be difficult.
That sounds like a pretty unforgiving security system.
Wampas can be fooled. A combination of synthetic pheromones and body language could make them think a Tals is part of their pack. All the more reason to bring back their equipment. We could learn much from the Tals.
The last thing you'd want to do in a Wampa cave is wear yourself down.
You'd be surprised how much I can carry.
Very well, then. Who am I to say if you've gone mad? Take anything of theirs that gives them aid or comfort. Make them come crawling. Let them know who the masters of this miserable world are.
Is confirmed.
Slowly.
Increasing combat pheromone.
I believe you requested Tal supplies, Captain Udris.
Excellent. I will search through these once the coming battle is over.
Which won't be long. Our sensors will catch the Tals, and our anti-personnel guns will obliterate them.
Commander! Commander! There's reports of a Tals attack!
Excellent. What wing are they headed for?
No wing, sir. They're at the power station.
These Tarls have no fear.
If they kill the power station, we'll have no heat.
Don't tell me you didn't think of this.
The station's guards won't be able to hold off the entire Tarls force.
I'll call for reinforcements from Adama's orbital. Just get to that power station, and quickly.
Are you well?
Your money's always good here. Come again.
At your service, sir.
Anonymity, deception. These are your tools.
Take it slowly.
Worthy decision. Agent, you shouldn't have.
Be well.
We are here. Show me a battle plan, or shut up and fight. Thank you.
Lieutenant Oron reporting in, my lord. Our company is on the ground and we have secured the perimeter.
Tell me you cut off their retreat.
We're the orbital reserve, sir. We did what we came to do. We'll finish up here. If you return to Dawn Base, Commander Triton will no doubt want to congratulate you in person.
Did you say the entire Tall's force was held off by one person? And they're not even a Sith?
It sounds incredible, to be sure, but here, I'll let you talk directly. Sir, our gratitude is overwhelming. We were just talking about you. May I introduce Moff Brainor, Overseer of the Hoth System, among others?
I'm surprised you'd take an interest in this humble base.
Your base is key to our activities on Hoth. And if not for you, it would have been lost. It is for that reason I ask you your opinion. Would you say Commander Triton or Chiss Captain Udris was more instrumental in the base's defense?
Captain Udris's advice formed most of our key strategies. We relied on him heavily.
That is as I expected. Very well. Captain Udris, you are now Colonel Udris. I am putting the base's welfare in your hands until further notice.
I don't believe I've heard of a Chiss ranking so high before.
It is unprecedented. But Captain Udris is well known for his skill and judgment.
Sir, if I might ask, do you think the enlisted men will have a problem taking orders from Colonel Udris?
You mean, will they refuse orders from a Chiss? They will at first. Then they will be made examples.
You could demonstrate your commitment by helping win the men over.
That is an excellent idea. I will begin immediately. Thank you, Moff Brainor.
Colonel Udris.
That will be all.
Well, that went better than expected.
I suppose we should be happy we don't have pirate problems here.
He's referring to another security failure. Captain Revar at Leth Outpost lost a reactor substation to the White Moor pirates. We have asked much of you, but Captain Revar has not, and his soldiers desperately need relief at the Leth Outpost. If you have the time, look in on them.
Increasing combat pheromones.